Hello, YouTube's Krosama, and here I have for you today is the High Grade Universal Century Sinanju Stein narrative version. This is coming from the Mobile Suit Gundam narrative version, which is due to release in theaters, I think, sometime late November, which I'm very excited to go ahead and see, because seeing the Sinanju Stein in action is definitely going to be a treat for the eyes. But hey, we got the Mobile Suit kit fairly early before the actual premiere, so I want to go ahead and dive right into what this kit is going to come with. Okay, so looking at the front cover, I think it looks pretty good overall. Nothing really too, I think, spectacular, but I always love thruster effects, so the blue effects coming from the back looks really awesome. And if I do have some thruster effects, I might actually go ahead and slap those on into the back just to go ahead and add a little bit extra detail to the kit overall. This was released in 2018, number 217 in the High Grade Universal Century line, and it comes in at 2,600 yen. So looking on the side, you basically see like the front and rear shot of the kit, and those thrusters look pretty good. I'm kind of curious if the inside of those thrusters are actually red, or if you're going to have to paint that yourself. Now looking down here on the weapons, you can definitely go ahead and see it's going to come with quite a large array of weaponry. So you have the bazooka, grenade launcher, shield, the high beam rifle, and the beam sabers, which is all really awesome weapons, especially the fact that it comes with the grenade launcher. I don't know, I just really like grenade launchers, so that's pretty awesome. And then over here you do see more of the details when it comes to those sleeves. Next, we're going to go ahead and look at the action poses. So you do see it comes with different hands, different weapons that can be interchanged with the bazooka attaching to the beam rifle, which I think is really awesome. I figured it was going to go ahead and happen anyways once I actually, you know, seen that it comes with that weapon. But, you know, really, really excited and kind of curious if the hand or the arm itself is going to be able to hold all that weight. And next, you just see the bazooka being utilized by itself. Thrusters right there on the legs have their own individual articulation, and then over here you have more thrusters which have their own individual articulation where they can move up and down. Then the beam saber is located right there on the forearm above the sleeve and has a pretty nice little shot with the shield and beam saber. Here's some information on the Sinanju Stein itself and a little piece of art on the side of the box. Alright, so starting with runner A, off the bat I can tell you I am just not a fan of this color. It looks like it's coming off pretty well on the camera. This is like a very, it's like a light gray. I don't like this. The color itself is fine, but the fact that the entire mobile suit is in this color, like the main parts, is just, I don't like this. I like the white look. So for example, the Sinanju Verka Master Grade, this white looks pretty good. I like this color. That's kind of like the main part about this mobile suit that I just really liked, was the fact that it was white, and you don't really see too many like majority white mobile suits outside of like Unicorn and like some special coating ones or special edition mobile suits. But this is just, to me, not acceptable. If the color was more like, if this was like a Master Grade, for example, and the color was separated between different parts, so like if this right here was this light gray, but then like this was white, and then this was also light gray or black, I mean, that'd be cool. It's different separation of colors, different tones. I'm completely fine with that. But for the entire thing to be in this color, vice white, I think that to me was a poor choice on Bandai's part. But color aside, let's just go ahead and start taking a look at details. The weapon right here looks really good. Lots of detail. So I'm definitely going to have my work cut out for me, because I am going to go ahead and paint this kit. The color is too distracting for me, and I want to go ahead and put it in my image that I have in my head. So I'm going to go ahead and, you know, definitely paint this white, but add, you know, those offset colors. So probably just add like some brown, some, you know, light gray and other colors all on the rifle itself. And I think that's going to come out fairly well. But yeah, the details look pretty good, especially in the head. I love the head sculpt right here, as you can see. And next we have is B1, which is going to be in two different runners. So let's just take a look at one of them. This is mainly going to be consisting of, like, looks like we got the fuel tanks right here. You also have leg pieces all around here at the bottom. And then this looks like it's going to be parts for the arm. But yeah, I think it looks pretty good as far as the terms of design. The thrusters look really, really great. And I'm just really excited that overall they decided to go ahead and utilize like new frames for all this. Like, all this is brand new to the Sinanju Stein. And next we're going to take a look at is Runner C, which is this nice blue. It looks like just a normal blue, maybe a dark blue. But I'm actually fine with this color. This, you know, the regular Sinanju Master Grade Verka essentially had the same exact color. So I'm fine with this. What I'm probably going to do, though, is make this a navy blue. If not navy blue, then I might start looking at, I don't know, like maybe just black, but I really don't want it to be a fully black and white kit, so I might just keep it a dark blue and just leave it as is, because I do like this color alongside that white. But you do have the shield, and you got just parts that are, you know, riddled all over the kit itself. And next we're going to have is Runner D. Runner D is going to be some of the inner frame, some nice little back skirts right here, which shows a lot of great inner detail, but you're also going to have some stuff for the waist, and then you have stuff for the actual rifle. You got the grenade launcher attachment as well, and over here you're just going to have some nice little pipings. You got parts for the top of the chest, and then you got some weapons. Now one did pop off, which I still have right here, but it was just loose in the package. And this is going to be for just some of the weapons. Looks pretty good. The hands look good as well. So no issues with this. But once again, this color, the brownish color, oh God, to me it looks so atrocious. I'm not a fan of like large brown parts on kits. Like, I don't know, like unless it's being weathered, that's cool. But like inner frame as this, like that just does not look good. I'd rather to be gunmetal or maybe just like a light gray, not light gray, but a dark gray, gunship gray. Those are fine colors, but this brown is just, I don't know, it's like poop brown, so not really too much of a fan of it. So I will be repainting all this, more likely just light gunmetal. And next we're going to have is E1 and E2. So E2 is just essentially a smaller part of this. More of the inner frame stuff, so it looks pretty good. You got the thrusters right here. Obviously you're going to have to paint some of this right here, because I mean these are a lot of details, which I think is going to be for the thrusters. So I would say I'll have to go ahead and put this kit together and see exactly where these parts are, because I know they're on the thrusters, but I don't know if this is supposed to be the red parts on the inside or not. I don't think so, but looks pretty good overall, so I'm actually pretty hyped to go ahead and start building this, put it together, see exactly where these details land, and then start planning my my detail kind of painting on what I'm going to do for that. But yeah, a lot of thrusters over here, like parts for thrusters, you got thrusters over here, so riddled with some nice veneers. And next is going to be G1, which is where all these sleeves are. So once again, a new little runner. Looks pretty good overall. Just going to have to do either a reverse wash, or if you have a steady hand, you can go ahead and individually paint these sleeves white or whatever color you're really trying to go with. But yeah, I'm going to go ahead and just keep all this black and then paint the white right over it. And it should look pretty good. And next we're going to have is G2, which is like this weird gray color. I don't really care for it at all. So I'm going to go ahead and repaint this as well. Don't really know exactly to what, but I'm going to go ahead and decide a little bit later on. But it's going to be parts for the torso right here. This looks like it's going to be parts for the legs. Could be wrong, but that's what it looks like. I had to definitely double check, and this looks like it might be parts for the thrusters. This is going to be parts for the forearms where the beam sabers go in. So yeah, overall not too many parts, but the color once again is not really to my liking. And here is Runner F, which is basically going to be the 2014 Neo Zeog Sinanju that comes with the bazooka. So looks pretty good overall. Still has good details. I mean, it's only been 4 years, so I'm pretty sure this thing, you know, holds up very well. But yeah, I'm definitely going to go ahead and paint this in a light gunmetal as well. You get two clear yellow beam sabers, a polycap sheet, and quite a few stickers that to me are just not going to be good no matter how you go ahead and put it. So you're going to have one for the shield up here. You got parts for the sleeves, and parts pretty much, you know, all over. So you're going to have a sticker sheet, which, I mean, it's just a sticker sheet. It's not really going to be that good. You're going to have to put in the work if you want your kit to really stand out. So these stickers are not going to do the part. You could just look at them, and you're instantly going to tell that these stickers are just not going to hold up, especially over time. So what I would recommend is definitely look up some tutorials on how to do reverse washing or any kind of, you know, panel, like not panel, but small detail painting, and then just trial and error. You know, definitely utilize this to go ahead and practice on. And now for the manual. The manual looks pretty good. Very, very basic Universal Century stuff. So you have a little color guide in here. Yeah, but looks pretty good. I definitely admire the engineering that came with this kit, because this thing is pretty much all new and has a lot of gimmicks. I've already kind of seen a lot of reviews already for it, and it's nothing but positivity. So overall, this is going to be a very, very nice little kit. And man, that bazooka attachment to the beam rifle looks really, really sick. So very, very, very excited to go ahead and get started on painting this kit. But I'm gonna go ahead and just build it first, and then after I build it, I will, definitely do a review, and then after the review, start painting, and then do a painted review. Other than that, you got some of the color guys down here. So you have that light gray, this regular gray that I wasn't really too fond of. So yeah, I'm definitely not gonna be utilizing any of this. I'm gonna go ahead and do my own little thing, and it should come out really, really good. And be a very good, pretty much a stand piece next to the Phoenix narrative version. But that's it for me, guys. Definitely thank you for watching. And like always, if you do like my videos, go ahead and like, comment, subscribe. Follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and any other social media platform that I posted. And I'll be seeing y'all in the next review. Bye-bye.